In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May the grace and peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good morning, everybody. Today is All Souls Day. This is the only day in the liturgical calendar that is not designated as a solemnity, a feast, or a memorial. So the church calls this a commemoration. We honor the dead. It goes all the way back to the early church. The church historian Tertullian wrote about it in the 2nd century. And it was widely celebrated in the latter part of the 9th century until Rome officially designated this day in the 13th century. And so we call to mind our sins, asking the risen Lord to feed us with his word and sacrament this day. Lord Jesus, you raise the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Listen kindly to our prayers, O Lord, and as our faith in your Son, raised from the dead, is deepened, so may our hope of resurrection for your departed servants also find new strength. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
You may be seated.
A reading from the book of wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed in the view of the foolish to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For if before men, indeed, they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastise a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine and shall dart about at sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love. Because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Beside restful waters he leads me, he refreshes my soul.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side, with your rod and your staff that give me courage. You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Only goodness and kindness all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism unto death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life. For if we have grown into union with him through a death like his, we shall also be united with him in the resurrection. We know that our old self was crucified with him, so that our sinful body might be done away with, that we might no longer be in slavery to sin. For a dead person has been absolved from sin. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. The word of the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia. This is the will of my Father, says the Lord, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him may have eternal life.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. In those days, Jesus said to the crowds, "Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and I will not reject anyone who comes to me, because I came down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of the one who sent me. This is the will of the one who sent me, that I should not lose anything of what he gave me, but that I should raise it on the last day. For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him may have eternal life, and I shall raise him up on the last day." The Gospel of the Lord. In her book, Walking Toward Morning, Victoria Safford writes about coming across an epitaph on a gravestone in an old New England cemetery. And this is what she wrote. "The name of the deceased and her dates have been scoured away by wind and rain, but there was a carving on a tree with roots and branches, a classic 19th century motif, and among them the words, 'She attended well and faithfully to a few worthy things.' At first, this seemed to me a little meager, a little stingy on the part of her survivors. But I wrote it down and have thought about it since. And now I can't imagine a more proud or satisfying legacy. She attended well and faithfully to a few worthy things. Every day I stand in danger of being struck by lightning and having the obituary in the local paper say, for all the world to see, 'She attended frantically and ineffectively to a great many unimportant, meaningless details.'" Today's commemoration of All Souls confronts us with the reality that our time on this earth is limited. Our God gives us this life in order to discover the good and embrace the holy, to realize the promise of God's kingdom in our lives. Today invites us to rediscover the meaning of our lives by remembering and giving thanks for all those we love and care for, and whose love and care for us mirrored the love of God. May we honor and remember with great gratitude our deceased relatives and friends on this All Souls Day. May our memories of them accompany us on our journey to God. Let their example inspire us, as the old New England gravestone marks, to attend well and faithfully worthy things. Continue our prayer as we lift up these many concerns and the names of all the faithful departed that will be written on our Facebook broadcast today.
That the Church may continue to grow in holiness as she spreads her message of salvation to the world, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That elected officials may be blessed with courage and compassion in their work to uphold the dignity and sanctity of life from conception through natural death. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who cannot practice their faith openly, that they may be upheld and strengthened through the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the love of God may be poured into the hearts of those among us who are grieving the loss of loved ones this past year. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially those that gave us the gift of faith, may they be shepherded by Christ to heaven to dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Leona and James Dickinson, for whom this Mass is offered, and for what or for whom do we pray today?
That have been submitted so far in our Book of Remembrance, for those whose images are in front of our altar, for those we will pray especially tonight in our Mass of Remembrance who were buried from our church 2 years ago. And so we say, eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. May they rest in peace. May the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen. You may be seated. friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept your sacrifice.
Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servants may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ, in him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you forever. Holy, 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 Lord God, heaven and earth. By sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving you thanks, he gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, your people spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, William, our Bishop, and all the clergy and religious. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with St. Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, the martyrs, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Pray the words that Jesus taught us. Our next after May.